What is going on, my family? Your boy Demetrius is back here with another Mortal Kombat 1 video. This video here, one thing that has really been the talk when it comes to Mortal Kombat has been Liu Kang and whether or not Liu Kang is going to screw up the timeline when it comes to Mortal Kombat 1. I have gone on record by saying that I think Liu Kang is going to screw up the timeline. At first, I was one of those people that kind of thought that Liu Kang would probably end up being the big boss in this game. But I don't think that's going to happen because of the reveal of Shao Kahn. Yes, I said Shao Kahn because I can't say General Shao. I just didn't grow up like that. You know, it's Shao Kahn. I'm sorry. I apologize. But it's Shao Kahn. So I can't go to General Shao. I didn't grow up saying that. But the reveal of Shao Kahn and Kronika kind of deadened that theory that Liu Kang may have been a big boss in this game. But I still do think that there is a possibility, like many other people think, there's the possibility that Liu Kang can fuck up this timeline. And here there is a poll that is, this poll was made by the Mortal Kombat content creator called Karmatim. I hope I'm saying that name right. Karmatim made this poll about Fire God Liu Kang and basically just asked people, do you think Liu Kang is going to mess up the timeline in Mortal Kombat 1? And as you see here, the results of the poll, and a lot of people do think that Liu Kang is going to screw up the timeline. And me personally, I am one of those people that think that Liu Kang is going to screw up the timeline. As a matter of fact, I'm going to go on record by saying Liu Kang is screwing up the timeline. And I have my reasons, and I have my predictions, and I have my evidence pointing to Liu Kang screwing up the timeline. Now, it's not concrete. I may be wrong. I don't think people have seen the ending yet. And I hope people, if they do see the ending, I hope people don't fucking spoil it. Because y'all know how it is with Mortal Kombat. People don't mind spoiling shit and people will be happy with it. No. So I hope people don't spoil it for us with these YouTube story videos. But yeah, I got a little bit of evidence that kind of points to Liu Kang possibly screwing up the timeline. I'm going to get into that. But before I do have to sit here and say, look, I gotta be all the way real with y'all. I am one of those people that has been getting sick of Liu Kang lately in the last few Mortal Kombat games, especially in Mortal Kombat 11, how this whole Fire God thing came about. I'm really getting kind of sick of Liu Kang, so I am kind of rooting against him when it comes to Mortal Kombat 1. I know that sounds kind of ridiculous, but me personally, I just kind of feel like as of right now, Liu Kang is probably the most overexposed main character that we have in a fighting game, and he's constantly getting shoved down our throats for no apparent reason. And it's the same thing here with Mortal Kombat 1. He's playing the role of Raiden, and they're still trying to find a way to make him the hero out of this whole thing, which don't make no fucking sense. But having said that, I just had to get that off of my chest and just let y'all know. And I'm just on some real shit when I say, hey, look, I'm kind of sick of Liu Kang and I am rooting against him. And the evidence that I have and my thoughts, I hope they do come true, because people just need to step up when it comes to Mortal Kombat. Other characters just need to step up and get a shine. The only way that they can do that is if Liu Kang is out of the picture. You know, that's just how it is. You know what I'm saying? I understand Liu Kang is the Mary Sue, so... But still, I'm rooting against this motherfucking character. I really am. But now I'm going to get into my predictions and my thoughts and reasonings why I feel like Liu Kang is going to fuck up the timeline. And there are a couple of things that I've already saw. I've talked to this with a couple of buddies of mine. And one of the things about it is, one of the first fuck-ups that I think Liu Kang did was to make Raiden Earthrealm's champion. And the reason that I say this, because I understand Raiden and Liu Kang did a character swap, which is kind of lame as fuck, if you ask me. They could have came up with something better than that, but, you know, another reason for them to shove Liu Kang down our throats. But Liu Kang appoints Raiden as Earthrealm's champion. And the thing about that is, Kung Lao is clearly a character that is ready for that type of task. At the beginning of Mortal Kombat 1, everyone saw it, how Kung Lao is just ready for something big. He said it himself. Kung Lao is ready for it. Not only that, Kung Lao defeated Raiden in a battle. So Kung Lao is clearly the better fighter in Mortal Kombat 1 than Raiden is. I don't understand how Liu Kang missed that. Y'all could put that in the comment section below. How the fuck did Liu Kang miss that shit? Kung Lao was clearly the better overall fighter, and he clearly had better determination when it came to, you know, being Earthrealm's champion. You feel what I'm saying? So I don't understand how Liu Kang missed that. I think Liu Kang did that on purpose. The reason that I think Liu Kang did that on purpose is because Liu Kang remembered in the last timeline of the cocky, arrogant Kung Lao, and Liu Kang is kind of using this to stick it to Kung Lao in the new timeline. It makes perfect sense, and I think that's what's going on right now. And then on top of that, by making Raiden Earthrealm's champion, don't y'all kind of think Liu Kang is trying to kind of delete the legend of the great Kung Lao by doing that? Now you point Raiden as Earthrealm's champion, so therefore the great Kung Lao and Shang Tsung, the legendary battle that started Mortal Kombat, does not happen. I kind of feel like that's where Liu Kang is fucking up at. He should have put Kung Lao in that spot, so it could have been possibly Kung Lao, Shang Tsung, or someone else, so that legend can either be born or live on. Another thing is, there's evidence out there, when Kung Lao and Liu Kang, when they get tangled up with each other, Liu Kang actually sits there and admits that nobody is ready for the legend of the great Kung Lao. He admitted that no one is ready to know about that. So if he's saying some shit like that, that means he's keeping the great Kung Lao from the legend. You feel what I'm saying? He's keeping that from everybody. So Liu Kang got some issues right there. I don't know what's going on, but that is one of the reasons why I feel like he's fucking up the timeline, because he is clearly trying to stick it to Kung Lao, and he's trying to really delete the legacy of the great Kung Lao, because Liu Kang said it his damn self. In connection to that, Shang Tsung. So Shang Tsung is practically lost in this timeline because of Liu Kang. So Shang Tsung doesn't have any powers. He's a beggar now and all of this. And I kind of feel like Liu Kang did that because he doesn't want that legendary battle between Shang Tsung and the great Kung Lao to happen. Now, but here's the problem. You make Raiden Earthrealm's champion. Shang Tsung is confronted by Kronika. So now Shang Tsung has the opportunity to be something super big, even probably bigger than the One Being. You feel what I'm saying? And I gotta go on record by saying I am not happy with Kronika being back into this game. Everybody hated her. NetherRealm knew it, and they brung her back into the fucking game. So with Kronika back, Shao Kahn back, I don't really see any room for the likes of Onaga or the One Being. I just don't see it happening. People are still saying Onaga is going to be in this game, but how, when you got all these big figures? You know, you got Kronika, you got Shao Kahn, you got Shang Tsung. You know, that's a lot of evil power. I know we were saying that it was going to have multiple enemies in Mortal Kombat 1, but those three characters right there, that's a big ass evil punch right there. Those three characters, Shang Tsung, Shao Kahn, and Kronika. So Onaga being in the game, I don't know about that. Can it still happen? I mean, Ed Boon said they want to add another character, so who knows? But I just don't see Onaga coming back in this game, not with all of that evil power that's going on with Mortal Kombat 1 right now with those three characters. But yeah, I'm not happy with Kronika being in this game. That's something that we should have saw coming. With Geras being in the game, we should have known Kronika was going to be in the game. But I'm not happy with Kronika being in the game. I'm really not. So those are my reasonings for Liu Kang fucking up the timeline. It's basically with Shang Tsung and Kung Lao. The fact that he basically made it to where these two characters will not meet in battle, he's fucking up the timeline right there. And me personally, I think Geras is going to turn on Liu Kang. And I think that's where all the chaos is going to go down. Geras is going to turn on Liu Kang, express his allegiance to Kronika, either Kronika or Shang Tsung. We don't know. Like I said, I'm just speculating, because Geras does watch the hourglass. So who knows what Geras could have done? There's a lot of ways that I can go with that. I could speculate a lot of things when it comes to Geras guarding that hourglass, but you know, maybe I'll do that in a separate video, because shit, I could come up with 50 reasons why that hourglass could have been manipulated. And I actually said this on Twitter. I do think Liu Kang is going to get killed in this game. He's either going to get killed, or he's going to sacrifice himself to save the realm that he's created. And maybe I think that's where Raiden is probably going to get his god powers back. And then I'm thinking that's where Raiden is probably going to regenerate the timeline himself. This is just a bold prediction, nothing true about it, but I feel like that's probably what's going to happen when it comes to the end of Mortal Kombat 1. And we're going to be right back where we started with Raiden being a god. He's probably going to bring Liu Kang back, and we're going to be back at square one. That's just my opinion, what's going on with Mortal Kombat 1. But, you know, we're going to see. We're going to see not too long from now. Mortal Kombat 1 is just a few weeks away. And like I said, I hope to Jesus that these content creators do not fucking spoil it for us. The ones that got the shit early, please don't spoil it for us. Please, I'm begging y'all, do not spoil it for us. You know what I'm saying? I know there weren't a lot of reasons, but they were big reasons. They were two big reasons why I feel like Liu Kang is messing with the timeline. And also, too, I kind of feel like Liu Kang, a lot of the chaos that's going on, Liu Kang is allowing it to happen to a certain extent. You know, the whole thing between the Lin Kuei versus Kung Lao and Raiden, Liu Kang let that shit happen. So he's letting a lot of this evil shit happen. I don't understand it. Why can't he just step into the middle of it and stop it like he would with Johnny Cage and Kenshi? So a lot of this shit, Liu Kang is allowing it. You feel what I'm saying? Y'all just gotta pay attention. He's allowing a lot of this shit to happen. So that's another reason why I feel like he's gonna fuck up the timeline. Certain things he allows, and then certain things he says, okay, we can't have this. And you know, that's kind of how Raiden was, and it got Raiden into a lot of trouble. So but like I said, I could go on all day, but I don't want to drag this video out, because you know, this video's main focus was, do you think Liu Kang was gonna fuck up the timeline? I basically just gave my opinion and gave my thoughts on why I think he will fuck up the timeline. So I just want to hear it from y'all. So put y'all comments in the comment section below. Tell me what you think. What are your thoughts and y'all feelings on Liu Kang possibly fucking up the timeline? Or is Liu Kang gonna be the same damn Mary Sue hero he's always been, even though he's a god and doesn't deserve to be a hero in the game? What do y'all think? Let me know in the comment section below. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe for more of this real talk Mortal Kombat 1 shit and other Mortal Kombat content. I will get back at y'all in the next video. God bless. Stay safe. I am out. Peace.